Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the third and final part in the Philips Lighting Academy three-part series titled Office Lighting to the Edge and Beyond. The third part in our three-part series features interior architect at Focoma and Partners, Babette Bowman.
Well, the funny thing about designing a flexible office space is to make real fixed elements and structure in your floors. So people will know where certain things are and they will be able to move themselves and adjust their own place to their own liking. I think the key topics for the future offices are the people and the young people especially, which are working on smartphones and are working on tablets and not so much on desktops. So they will be more flexible and you have to adjust the office to their needs. And of course you need the technology and take the health in consideration. I think the future of the office will look more like meeting places, more like cafeterias, more like a nice place to meet your colleagues. And if you want to have your quiet places, then you go somewhere else, maybe at home, maybe in an office. But I think the future of the office will be more of meeting and talking to people and collaborating. Designing this building as a multi-tenant, but exclusively for Deloitte and Arcadé. And during this process, there was some sort of a crisis, so they did not take all the floors of the building. So they rented them out right now to different kind of firms. So now it is really a multi-tenant building. We designed it with security and stuff like that for the multi-tenant, so it really used to be a multi-tenant all along. Lighting was included in our design at the first steps that we tried to design this entire building. For instance, the atrium was an important part because we do have a lot of natural light, but we also need the wall washers to give the walls that you walk into a nice glow and a warm feeling. And we also have the lights beneath the stairs, and we added some additional lights on the cabriolets to give to make certain spaces underneath them. On the work floors, we try to have the additional lights near the pantries and in other areas of the work floor to get a more comfortable, homey kind of feeling and environment. The trend in interior is really sustainability right now. And the reuse of materials is also a hot topic nowadays. We see two kinds of things. So one is the technology that's supporting our way of working, and the other one is considering about the environment. One thing to achieve this BREEAM Outstanding rating was to get the people to sit within the 7.5 meters from the facade. And another thing for the materials was, for instance, that we had to choose the right carpet with an eco backing and to use the right glue. That were mainly the important things to consider during this project for us. Let me tell you a bit more about the technology in this building. It has also to do with your climate system. It has also to do with your iPhone. Your iPhone you can place anywhere and you can adjust your climate and your light according your liking that day. So if the sun's shining, you can tone everything down, and that's a really comfortable way of working. You can work throughout the entire building. The connected lighting system gives you a lot of freedom to wander around and add your favorite to your workspace. So if you're in a concentration room or if you're in a meeting room, you can adjust your lights however you like. So that's a great thing to have in a building like this. The impact of connected lighting is that we are more flexible in designing our workspaces. And I think that it will complement the agile working environment more than it used to do. So that's a great thing. It's a great development. We always are re-educating ourselves by taking a look at other firms and, for instance, Philips, who is developing these lights. And they've asked us to give us their view about the design of future LED LED lights. So we are going to be cooperating in designing new light systems. It is true that Philips is also learning from our design perspective, because we are making new concepts for companies, and we know what they want, and we'll just have to support their needs in these concepts. Nowadays, the buildings are more smart buildings, and I think that's an interesting cases to take in consideration as you make a new design. So there's always a lot to learn, and you do that by evaluating the project you did before. So you'll move on to the next and doing it better. I think, from my point of view, that intelligent lighting is a really interesting topic. But I think it's especially nice to have in stores, and where you really can make your own setting with these lights. I think the concept of a work environment is a bit tough to get the lighting exactly right for every person. So it will just be the light on your table, and that's what you need for working, and it's a bit dull if you take a look at it. I think the controllability gives you more freedom to adjust your light. If for instance the sun's shining outside, then you can adjust your lights. I think you end up most of the day with 300 lux, and it will stay that way wherever you go and wherever you sit. So I think it's nice to have. The main reason to give people control over their own environment is that they feel more comfortable, and they always like to open their own windows. They always like to adjust their own climate, and they really like to adjust their own light. One of the challenges will be that if you have a smart system like this, then you need to get them on board at the start of the design process. And that's when you get the best results. That's also for installation, but nowadays also for lighting systems. If you want a smart building and a smart system, you have to get them at the start of the design process. I think the initial costs are maybe a bit higher at the beginning of the process, but I think you can earn it back, because a lot of lights are not on all day, and it's an intelligent system, so it will respond to the use of it. But there is one downside, and I think the adjustability above the ceiling, if you have to adjust something, that is going to cost a lot of money, and we'll have to look at that to get that one better next time. After we heard we got this connected lighting system, we already had the layouts ready, so there was no extra difficulty getting this system in. It worked really well in the layout we had. I think the opportunities for connected lighting are larger than we can see right now, because I think the environment of offices will change more to like a retail or a cafeteria interior. So I think then it will be quite nice to have. We're going to see a lot more intelligent lighting, for instance, for wayfinding. You nowadays see it also woven into carpets and stuff like that, to get you in and out of a building, and to maybe, for instance, have your advertisement inside your carpet. So I think intelligent lighting has a lot more to offer than just the adjustment of your workplace.